It is 12 minutes after 9. Thanks for being with us on Live at 9. The full cost of the opioid crisis continues to rise as that epidemic grows. The cost of the crisis does not just include, of course, the dangerous drugs themselves, but the value of lost lives, increases in health care costs, and criminal justice costs as well, and even reductions in productivity across the country. Now the federal government says the dollar amount is in the trillions.
But government and health officials on the local, state, and federal level are working to combat the nationwide destruction every day. Here this morning with us is addiction counselor Brett Martin. Brett, welcome back to Live at 9. Good to see you.
Yeah, thanks for having us.
Where do we stand these days? How bad are things? Have they gotten any better?
I think, you know, a lot of the problem is still the same. You know, the good thing is that we're talking about this, you know, about the problem now.
True.
We're also talking about the solutions. You know, for the longest time, we didn't want to talk about addiction. We didn't want to talk about the opioid epidemic. Mm. Now we are. I'm here. You all talk about it often.
Right.
You all cover the stories. But now we're also talking about the solutions. So I think that's the step in the right direction. Unfortunately, here in Memphis, in Tennessee, we saw an increase in 2018.
Why do we think that is?
I think there's a lot of different factors. I think, you know, you mentioned just economics, the social classes, things like that. The amount of pills are still out there.
Yeah.
We're still seeing too many pills on the streets.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, back years ago, they were just flooding the streets out there. Now we're learning, again, those solutions. So we're making steps. Unfortunately, if you ask me, losing one life is one too many.
Right.
So sure.
So does the most progress, or can, I guess, what can individuals do? We can wait for the government to do something. We can wait for lawsuits to work their way through the courts and hold Big Pharma accountable for its part in this years ago, which we're seeing.
We are.
But what can we as individual members of the community do? Anything?
Talk about it. Be there. You know, I always say when somebody's reaching up for help, be that helping hand to lift them up.
So don't ignore
them.
Problems or symptoms in your own household.
Absolutely.
What about we as family members, especially if we see it in our own households, which many people do, unfortunately, these days.
We do. You know, unfortunately, we see a lot of folks, you know, I think they say 75% to 80% of addictions, especially with opiates, start in the medicine cabinet.
Yeah.
So again, we always encourage people, treat those medicines like a loaded weapon. A loaded weapon can kill you, so can these medicines. We're seeing that. So do that, but also if you start to see differences in your loved ones, get the ball rolling. Just start talking. Call me, call Turning Point, call anyone.
Yeah. Differences like what,
yeah,
for
what
example?
Are some of those?
If you start to see mood changes, see just, you know, lethargic, just not wanting to be a part of things. We're coming up on the holidays. We talked about it last year around the holidays. If they seem to distance themselves around them because they don't want to come to the Thanksgiving table, they don't want to come to Christmas morning. If you start to see them kind of pull back, start asking questions. Don't accuse them. Just ask questions because you want to help. Get that ball rolling. There's a lot of resources out there, both public, private, for-profit, non-profit. As a matter of fact, when I leave here, I'm going to a meeting that's going to be a group of everyone, Shelby County Health Department, nonprofits, for-profits. You know, get the ball rolling.
Is it a human tendency to ignore that kind of behavior initially? You know, if you're a parent, nobody wants to consider that it could happen in your family. So we have to fight our own natural tendency.
Exactly. Fight back that stigma that is maybe just naturally born. You know, nobody wakes up and wants to be a heroin addict.
Right.
You know, I've lost people in my family. I've lost people close to my inner circle to it. I'm sure you all, anybody watching, has somebody or knows somebody that is struggling with an addiction. So, you know, put that aside and be there to help out.
Do you feel as if we are doing enough on a state, local level here? Could there be more done?
Of course there could always be more done from everyone, including myself. You know, there's always, again, we're losing people. I just heard just this week another young man lost his life to this. Mm-hmm. So we're still losing people. So of course there's more to be done. You know, from a state level, we have the SOAR grant, mm-hmm. which is huge, state opioid response team. They're based right here in Memphis. They're you know, no insurance. Anybody can just call this 1-800 number and get help. You can call me and I can connect you with SOAR.
Okay.
You know, there are things happening, again, working those public-private relationships, because it's going to take a village. It really is. It's going to take everybody coming to the table and helping out so that we can stop losing these levels.
The problem is just that big.
Yeah, you guys are 24/7, so we've put your hotline on.
Yes,
you know, any time of the day or night, even if it's your loved one you're concerned with, call, get some advice.
There's the information right there.
Yeah, exactly. You know, give us a call. We can answer. I'm local. I'm right. right here. You call that number and ask, hey, I need somebody in the Memphis area to come talk to my loved one, okay, because I don't know how to approach them.
Sure. Yeah.
They'll reach out to me, and we're going to make it happen. We want to be, you know, I always say I'm going to answer my phone because it could be the last phone call somebody makes.
All right. Which is, thank you so much.
We appreciate you being here.
Thank you.